So the bladder lies downstream of your kidneys. Your kidneys filter your blood. And what they do is they filter out all the toxic materials and they send them down to your bladder where they're stored as urine. 90% of bladder cancers or more arise in the superficial skin layer of the bladder and the structures that go up toward the kidneys. Bladder cancer is almost always associated with blood in the urine. And blood in the urine can also be caused by a variety of different things. And so having an awareness that blood in the urine can mean bladder cancer and having that be on a physician's radar screen is critically important. So bladder cancer occurs in about 3 times as many men as it does in women. Women, however, get a more aggressive form of the disease. 9 out of 10 patients who present with bladder cancer over the age of 55. There's about a 2- to 3-fold increase in risk if you're a smoker. And about 2/3 of cancers, a little bit more, are cancers that are really not life-threatening. We call them non-muscle invasive. Some call them superficial. The problem for clinicians is that these cancers come back over and over again. And so patients with this type of disease require lifelong follow-up. And so it's surprising to some people that bladder cancers of this kind are the most expensive cancers to treat because of this lifelong surveillance. And then the other kind of bladder cancer is called muscle invasive. This is a very aggressive form of the disease, and for patients with this form of the disease, the option to do lifelong surveillance is not on the table. These patients have to have immediate therapy, and this involves either a choice between having the bladder removed completely, or in some cases it's possible to use radiation and chemotherapy to leave the bladder intact. And so we are launching a very aggressive, multidisciplinary approach to bladder cancer care that will involve in-depth meetings about every single patient by the whole team. By sharing information, sharing ideas, this is the way to move the research forward.